Hi everyone. I thought I'd make a video of the seedlings that I started back in February. You can see on my video back February 2nd, I believe it was, that I started these seeds. And last time you saw them, they were little tiny things that I was transplanting.
What I've been doing is on nice days, taking them outside and letting them be out in the sun and then bringing them back, back and forth.
So this is my holding spot here on this table next to my sliding door. And I just move them in and out, and I cannot wait until I don't need to do this anymore. It's 2 months, and it's amazing what you can grow in 2 months when you start with a little tiny seed. It's a miracle, really. It's just amazing. But, you know, here they are. They don't look great, but they've hung in there, and I'll give you a little tour. These are the tomato plants. I only have three varieties. I have, San Marzanos, I have Tigerellas, and I have a Snowberry, which is a little small cherry tomato that grows really well. So, you know, I had them labeled to begin with. And then as I've transplanted them multiple times, I just lost track. So I don't even know which are which.
So it'll be a surprise.
These are my peppers that I started at the same time. And they had gotten pretty tall, maybe up here. But then I saw Ray on the Praxis channel prune them. And I thought, you know what? I've never done that before. Let me give it a try. And I fed them really well afterwards, and I'm getting some growth, and so maybe I'll have bushier plants instead of these spindly things. And then here are the eggplant that I started back in February at the same time. Here's some more different
peppers.
Got
some wind damage, but
other than that, they're looking good. The growth is coming back here where I trimmed the top off. And those I kept labeled, thank goodness, so I know what they are. And the tomatoes I've tried to stake up because I want to keep them trained in an upright, you know, position. But then some of these don't have any sticks, and they're just flopping everywhere. And over here I have, this is a ground cherry. It's the first time I've ever grown a ground cherry, but it's doing really well, and it has little flower buds growing on there. So I'll probably pinch those off because the plant's still pretty small, but it's got a nice look to it, and it's a pretty plant. Hope to taste that this year. I'd like to see how ground cherries taste. I've heard they're pretty good. The next time you see me with these plants will be when I'm putting them in the ground or they're already out in the ground. So take care. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.